it's pretty frustrating to be biking and have someone pass you like super close. The point of the project is to create a map of where it's safe and not safe to bike. I was thinking about what are the things that happen that are correlated with car crashes or maybe indicate that a car crash might happen. One of those things is obviously how close cars pass bikes. If a car passes a bike extremely close, they might actually hit them. I'm from a sensing lab and the work I do is building devices. And so for this project, I wanted to build basically a device that could fit into a bike really seamlessly. It's basically just a proximity sensor, and it's designed to sort of go into the bike handlebars. It detects how close cars are passing you. When cars pass cyclists below 3 feet, that is considered not safe. So I'm basically just moving the sensor closer and further away from this surface here. You can actually see right on the screen these numbers of the rear and the side proximity sensor are going up and down. I handed it out to a bunch of cyclists, and we had, what was it, 1,000 miles traveled over 2 months in Seattle. Close passes or near misses. The map is a way of visualizing the data. And so what we found is that in the locations where there have been a higher frequency of historic car crashes in the last 5 years, when you overlay the map of this 5-year historic collisions and the close passes over 2 months, there's a lot of places where the signal is pretty much the same. The real end goal of the project is to create a map like this that, you know, some platform like Google Maps would use so that someone who's interested can just look it up. People don't really feel comfortable getting on a bike, and I want to change that.